Arizona Territory, 1868, Chokchi's County. The air is dry and the sun strongly beats down over Tombstone. American settlers have taken their place in the county, families springing and birds blooming. Yet a ruinous hell roams the plains, the Chokchi's Red Sash Gang. Notable as cattle thieves, they've increased in size and threat. The Mexican government ended up having to add forts along their border to protect against smuggling. Yet, nothing stopped the Red Hell from ransacking, ravishing, and killing. They hold up stagecoaches, rob the banks, shoot the lawman. William Brocious, better known as Curly Bill, leads the bastards. His right-hand man and most valued is Hugh Slade, better known as Silver Hand Slade. He is one of the sharpest gunslingers the gang has. As casualty numbers rise, the word becomes quite spooky around Tombstone. People keep quiet. Lawmen steer their own path, trying to avoid the outlaw cowboys at all cost, as Red Hell runs wild.
Can of beans?
From the saloon down the street.
Why don't you get me a can?
Get your own damn beans.
Ringo, hand me over your pistol.
Johnny Ringo, aren't you?
Yeah.
You just killed that sheriff, huh?
He deserved it.
That's a pretty nice shot.
I'd say so.
So you know Curly Bill?
Yeah, he's introduced to my cousin.
That's what I hear.
He has the Red Sashes, aren't you?
So you trying to join the gang?
Hell yeah.
This is Billy. My name's Slade.
Nice to meet you.
Billy.
All right, Johnny. Right here. So look, when you're pulling the gun, you want your finger on the trigger already, ready to shoot. So here's your quick draw, just like this. Not bad, kid. Looks like you deserve that smoke.
I think so.
Thank you.
Johnny Ringo, boys, we want your guns.
We'll show you the guns, Lawsies.
You by chance ain't got a cigar on you, do you?
No, sir.
Back in the way.
God damn it, Slade!
Why'd you have to pick a canyon for a shootout? I told you, shoot your head south.
I got no cover. No cover, Slade, cover me.
Get him, Ringo.
Wrong place, wrong time, Law Dog. Throw guns.
Where are you riding up from?
Tombstone. Got plenty more riding up. You guys will be dead before sundown.
Believe that, Ringo?
You think? Hell no.
I think it's a crock of shit.
Sorry, boys. It's your grave, not mine.
What do you say? We just kill him right here, right now?
Say we shoot him.
You booked the boys that shot my deputy, Frank Lloyd, here?
Yes, we did. And you'll be joining them soon. Any last words?
Can I enjoy one last smoke?
What do you think, Ringo? We give this boy a smoke right before we kill him?
Yeah, hell, he's going to hell anyway.
Mixed up.
You ever been to Tombstone?
I've never been to Tombstone. I have no clue what you're talking about.
You're that new deputy. Hank J. Huey. That's right, Huey. You're that new deputy that started 3 weeks ago.
Now, Hugh, what the hell is he talking about?
This boy's on something. I swear I have no clue.
Bullshit.
What are you talking about?
Bullshit. He started last week. I showed you the rope, showed you the town.
I've never seen this man in my life, Ringo.
Ringo, I think you got a lawman on your hand.
Thank you.
boys started going on a spree of getting themselves in trouble. Their kill count had climbed to 15 people per man. Their luck was strong, and they were true outlaws at heart, roaming the plains, robbing the dry gulch towns of their dignity. They traveled throughout several areas of the Chalk Cheese County and set up camp in different random locations every time to avoid leaving up trails for lawmen. They often would meet Billy Clanton at the Tombstone Saloon, causing several folks to go home that night due to chances of something bad happening. Sometimes one small incident that isn't even much of a fussing about can set off a bad fate.
Hey, fellas, how you doing?
He threatened to kill old Johnson. He's going to jail tonight, trial tomorrow.
Now look, you didn't do nothing, all right?
Back down, partner, or you'll be joining him.
You'll be joining him soon.
Billy, let's wait on this one. We'll get him later.
To hell with these dogs.
That's right, boys. Move along.
In the meanwhile, Slade recognized over a growing superstition that the Red Sashes were not the outlaws he had envisioned. He realized things were going too far and too grim for him. Whether it was destiny or an act of God, pure righteousness had fallen on Slade, hoping the Lord would forgive his sins of murdering all those folks he did. Redemption was a word. Slade knew he had to redeem himself. There was only one way.
Shit, man. Somebody should have brought beans or something, man. I'm fucking starving.
Well, some beans, we're gonna have to commit another train robbery.
I'm all for that, man. They don't call me Buckshot for nothing. You know what's gonna happen when they see these fucking red flags flying around?
Lawmen will go running like flies.
I'll shoot me some bad boys. I can do that. Pow! Pow! Pop them motherfuckers one at a time, man. That's what I live for.
What do we really see for anyways? What do you mean? What are you, some kind of pissant?
We wear these because Curly wanted us to, goddammit. And that's all I know, and that's all I need to know.
Agreed.
Ringo was vicious, but he wasn't stupid. He knew Slade had killed his own men. Every Red Sash alive knew Slade had turned to the law. Johnny's soul was bound for hell, accompanied by a pale horse to make sure he gets there. He was guaranteed to be damned. His care for Billy and Slade was diminished. All he could want was death. All he could breathe was death. He had no morals anymore, only an emotionless gun with a hand to pull the trigger.
Hey, Johnny, I didn't tell no her.
Huh, that's interesting. Wonder how the lawman knew my boys were camped up at Oak Grove.
I didn't tell no herbs.
You know, some families are just born weasels and rats. I enjoyed putting your scumbag father down, just like I'm gonna do you.
Don't do it!
Johnny.
Curly, we have a problem. I think Slade's on the lawman's side.
My men have been ruthlessly, cowardly executed by Slade. Can you believe I allowed my trust for a mere second on a rat? You're going to prove yourself to me. Take his sister, shoot her in front of him, then blow his head off.
Where's he at?
I think it's called Devil's Creek. Him and his sister will be there.
All right, Curly. Get it done.
How you doing?
Good. What are you up to?
I was just looking over some papers. What you been up to?
Tending to the cattle.
Nice.
Gotta
nice.
Go to the bank, fetch some coins. Need a drink?
Yeah, if you're buying.
I'll be right back.
Hey, bartender. You pouring me up a whiskey?
Brandy.